I'm clearly no metal worker, and I don't normally have to do this to my 3D printers. But this one is too loud, so the only way to fix it is with surgery. Loud surgery, with sparks. It's all part of my plan to make it quieter, and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello 3D printing friends and welcome back. Today on the BV3D channel, I'm surgically altering my Sovol SV08 and I'm inviting you along for the ride so you can see how to do it yourself and why you would even want to do this in the first place. So, what's going on? Well, the SV08 has a problem that's bothered me so incredibly much that within the first day of having the thing in my possession, I had to do something about it. And the problem is that the mainboard cooling fan is ridiculously loud. It's made worse by the fact that this annoyingly loud fan is always on, so the printer is always making noise when it's powered up, even if it's not printing. Part of that is just that the fan itself isn't the quietest thing ever, but the thing that really pushes the noise over the top is that the fan grill is right up against the fan blades. They're very nearly touching. And when a fan grill is that close to the fan blades, it amplifies the noise level. I don't know why that happens, I just know that it does. It's irritating as heck and nobody should have to put up with it. When it comes to loud printers, I'm not a fan. So let's talk about solutions. There are a few ways to fix this horrible noise problem. We can slow down the existing fan. We can add a gap between the fan blades and the grill. We can reduce the amount of air that the grill blocks, or since larger fans can often be quieter than smaller ones, we can try that. My initial solution combined the first three things. I used a buck converter to reduce the voltage going to the fan, which made the fan spin slower, and that reduced the noise. I also cut away the existing fan grill with a Dremel tool and used a wire fan grill in its place. That actually did two things. It added a gap between the fan blades and the grill and reduced the amount of air the grill blocked. But because this approach used a buck converter, it involved additional electronics and soldering. So for a solution that doesn't require electronics or soldering skills, using a larger fan in combination with a wire fan grill is probably the way to go. And coming up right after this, that's exactly what we're going to do. Hey, if you're getting value from this video, a subscribe would mean a lot to me. That lets me know that I'm making content you enjoy and you want to see more like it. Thanks! So in order to implement this solution, we're going to need a bigger fan and a wire fan grill. I picked these up on Amazon and there's a link in the description if you want to get the same ones. This is a 24-volt 6010 fan, which will replace the stock 24-volt 4010 fan. Those numbers mean it's a 60 millimeter diameter fan and it's 10 millimeters thick. Fortunately, this fan's connector is wired exactly the same as the stock one. On other printers, when replacing fans, I usually have to swap the position of the black and the red wires, but this one was already set up correctly. Oh, and here's the fan grill, also sourced from Amazon. I picked up this particular one because it also included the screws, which are kind of thick, and are designed to go right into the fan's screw holes. And that means I don't need to source screws and nuts and washers and stuff. Some simple tools will also be useful, like a Dremel tool and a drill. Because in order for this fan to fit, we need to cut a larger opening in the sheet metal on the bottom of the printer. To make that a little easier, I designed a template you can download and print. Using a pencil or a fine tip marker, you can draw where to cut and where to drill so the new fan can be installed. So let's get started. First, turn off the printer and unplug it, and then turn it onto its side. Remove the screws holding the sheet metal panel onto the bottom of the printer. Then remove the panel, being careful to unplug the fan from the mainboard. Set the sheet metal down on your work area. Then, just to be sure, compare the connectors on the old and the new fans. Like I said a minute ago, my new fan was wired the same as the original one, but double check yours, and if you need to swap the black and the red wires on your new fan, now is the time to do that. Then, unscrew the original fan from the sheet metal. Position the template so that it's roughly centered on the original fan position. Mark where you need to drill for the screw holes and then trace along the inside of the template to draw the cut line for the new fan. then cut out the larger opening. I thought I could be clever and just use my nibbler tool to cut up to the lines, but there were two problems with that approach. One, the sheet metal is kind of thick, so it's difficult for the nibbler tool to bite through. And two, the threaded holes for the original fan screws have some big threaded inserts in them, and they're kind of in the way of where the nibbler tool wants to nibble. So I ended up using the Dremel to cut out the larger opening. Like I said at the beginning, I'm clearly no metal worker. This was a slow, noisy process, and I went through two cutoff wheels on the Dremel tool. It's like 20 or 25 years old, and it blows uncomfortably hot air out the vents that are right up by the business end where you're supposed to hold it. So I wasn't able to keep good control over it and snapped a couple of cutoff wheels. Maybe I'm just not cut out for this, but 15 minutes of sparks and noise later, I had the cutout cut out. Then I drilled out the holes for the screws. And apologies here, I thought I had pressed record, but based on the lack of video evidence, I failed to do that. With the holes drilled and the cutout cut out, screw the new fan grill to the fan, sandwiching the sheet metal between the two. Do all four screws and make sure the fan and the grill are held securely in place. Then plug the fan into its socket on the mainboard and put the sheet metal base back into place. The last step, of course, is turning the printer back on and enjoying a quieter experience. After doing this mod in an otherwise completely quiet room, measured 1 meter from the printer, the sound level is around 38 decibels when the printer is powered on but not printing. That puts it on the high side of whispering nearby and just below quiet library sounds, according to this webpage listing the loudness of everyday sounds. Unfortunately, I didn't measure the noise level when I first got the printer, but I know it was loud. If you want to do a before measurement of an unmodified SV08 in a quiet room at a distance of 1 meter from the printer, feel free to comment with your readings. I'm curious what you get. To me, it no longer sounds like a small vacuum cleaner, and that makes me happy. So the printer is quieter, but at what cost? Well, I got the fans as a 4-pack for $8, so each fan was $2 a piece. And I got the fan grills and screws as a 4-pack for about $6, so those ended up being $1.50 a set. My total spend was about $14, but only a quarter of that went into the printer. So for $3.50 worth of parts, this is an arguably cheap way to make the Sovol SV08 quieter and more pleasant to be around. I gotta say, when it comes to quieter printers, I'm definitely a fan. If you want to get these exact fans and grills, I've got links to them in the description. Thanks for watching, and big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using those links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one, and now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.